Welcome to Communication Engineering Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be solving examples based on amplitude modulation from previous year GATE examination question papers. So here, this is the first question that I'll be solving in this session, where you'll be finding message signal, that is MT is equals to cos of 2 pi f MT, and carrier frequency, that is FC, which of the following represents sideband of SSB. So single sideband of SSB, that is what we need to identify out of four equations. So if you see first equation, so that is what equation of DSBSC, that is what carrier signal into MT, it means it is DSBSC. Now if you see second option B, so that is just a carrier signal. So this is just a carrier signal. Now if you see third option C, so that is having frequency component FC plus FM, means it is upper sideband. And only one sideband is there, it means it is what? SSBSC signal. And if you see fourth equation, so that is somewhat similar to AM standard form. AM standard form. So now I think it is very clear, like what is SSB signal over here? Option C, this is what SSB signal which is there in this question. Now let us solve next question. Now see, in this question, message signal that is given by MT is equals to half of cos of omega 1t minus half of sin of omega 2t. In amplitude modulated signal with carrier frequency omega c that generates ST is equals to this 1 plus MT cos of omega c t. What is the power efficiency by this modulation scheme? So to calculate power efficiency, first we need to identify this modulating index of this modulating signal. Here multitone modulating signal is there. So modulating index from this, if you place that in this equation, then you will be finding it. So ST, now that will be 1 plus, I'm placing just MT here, half cos of omega 1t minus half cos of omega 2t into cos of omega c t. Now see, this is multi-tone input signal. So one tone is having modulating index, let us say this, so that is half, means 0.5, and second tone that is having modulating index M2, that is even 0.5. So from that we can calculate resultant modulating index. M is equals to M1 square plus M2 square. So you will be finding it will be half square plus half square. So that is 1 by root 2. So resultant modulating index, that is 1 by root 2. Now see, from this signal, even we can identify what is carrier amplitude. AC is equals to 1. So carrier power PC is equals to AC square by 2. So that is half. So carrier power, that even we can identify, that is half. Now we need to calculate sideband power. So I'm just calculating here. Sideband power, that is mu square by 2 into PC, where mu is modulating index, so that is 1 by root 2. So if I place that, so that is half into carrier power, that is even half. So this is 1 by 8. So now we can calculate efficiency. So that is sideband power by total power, so that is PS plus PC. So here I need to solve this. So if I place values, PS that is 1 by 8 divided by half plus 1 by 8. So 1 by 8 divided by half means 4 by 8 plus 1 by 8 means 5 by 8. So this is 1 by 5. And in terms of percentage into 100 that I need to multiply, so that will be 20%. So we can say efficiency of this is 20%. See, that is how we can solve this type of problem regarding GATE examination. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can suggest me those things which is required here. Definitely I'll try to sort out all those issues. And you just practice along with me. Definitely you'll find everything regarding GATE as well as subject. And you will be able to score very good in your university examination even, as well as in GATE examination. Thank you so much for watching this video.